8393 Fundamentals of Data Structures in C, Second Year ECE, Third Sum, presented by Anuja R. AP CSE, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. The course objective, to develop C program using the concept of looping, branching, arrays and string. The objective of the particular course is the ability of student to develop the knowledge about basic of C programming improves engineering knowledge on complex problem. The first topic of unit 1 is structures of C. So this is the syntax of structure of C program. The first one is documentation section, then link section, definition section and global declaration section. The next part is main function. So we can declare here two subparts, that is declaration part, another one is executable part. The next one is subprogram sections. Here we can include some functions. Another one name of the subprogram section is also called as user defined function. Then the definition of the particular structures. The first one is document section. The document section consists of a set of commands line given to the name of the program. Then link section, it provide instruction to the compiler to link or include the required input functions. That is, example is hash include directives, hash include stdio.h, like that. The definition section, it define all the symbolic constants using the hash defined directives and having the constant being defined here. Here we are using the constant value as pi is equal to 3.14. Then global declaration section. In global declaration section, the variable that are used in more than one function. And it is also called as a variable and or declare in the global declaration section, that is outside of all the function. Next one is main function. So instead of this main function, it contains two part, that is declaration part and the one is executable part. And declaration part consists of it declare all the variables used in the executable part. Then the executable part, so there is at least one or more statement in the executable part designed for some text or executing some logic. So these two part must appear between the opening and closing braces, and also it execute begins at the opening brace and end at the closing brace. So these closing brace of the main function is the is the logical end of the program, and the statements in the declaration and executable part end with the semicolon. Then the subprogram section. In subprogram section that contain two parts, one is main function program, another one is user defined function. So the main function is nothing but the section contain defines all the user defined function which are declared earlier in the definition section. The user defined function consists of it is generally placed immediately after the main function, although they may appear in any order. So this is also the another structure of C program. First we can declare the preprocessor directive, then global declaration part, then we can declare the main function. So instead of the main function, we can define local definitions as well as statements, return zero, then close the braces. So this is the simple example for the structure of C program. So the C program contain one or more functions where a function is defined as a group of statement that perform as well the defined task, right? The statement in a function are written to the perform a specific task. Here the main function is the most important function and is a part of every C program and program. Then the execution of C program begins with main function. Then the program statement, it perform an action when a program is executed. Then preprocessor directive, it tells the preprocessor to look for special code library, make substitution in the code and in other way prepare the code for translation into machine language. The next one is declaration statement. The name and type of the data object need during the program execution. The example is integer A. Integer is the data type, A is a variable. Then expression statement, it is the simplest kind of statement. We can declare the expression is x is equal to a plus b into c cap 4, right? Then compound statement, it is a sequence of statement that may be treated as a single statement. Then label statement, the label statement is used to mark any statement so that control may be transferred to the statement by switch statement. So here also we are using case and we can write the label. Then control statement, it can be used to check whether the condition is true or false. Then selection statement allows the program to select a particular execution path from a set of one or more alternatives, right? Then iteration is execute a group of one or more statement repeatedly. The example of iteration is for, while, do while, etc. Then jump statement, it is an unconditional jump to some other place in the program. The example of jump statement is go to statement. Thank you.